Hi, AT from CNC at home. I've had a few people request to kind of show how things work behind the scenes with the laser. What I use is a program called LightBurn. So I'm going to go through and do a little demonstration of some of the features within LightBurn. As I press anything on the keyboard that's not a menu, I will try to mention that that's what I'm pressing. Anyway, what I'd like to show is just a simple project, and that's how to make a clock face within LightBurn. It's relatively simple, but I thought I'd just go through how we can do that. So to start with, I'm going to grab the circle tool. I'm going to come over here, and while holding the shift key, I'm just going to make a random sized circle. By holding the shift key, it makes a perfect circle. If I don't hold the shift key, then I can make a variety of circles and ovals and that sort of thing. All right, so now that we have our circle, I'm just going to give it a size. I'm going to come up here and type in 100. And then I'm going to go anchor it in the lower left corner of the screen. And then by clicking up here, that'll zoom in. Now, the reason I chose 100 is it's a nice even number. This is all going to be vector graphics. I can scale this to whatever size I want. So as long as this looks good here, we should be fine. So the next thing I want to do is select my circle, and then I'm going to make two sets of hash marks that go around the circle. There'll be a larger hash mark for each hour, and then there'll be smaller hash marks that represent the minutes. To do that, I'm just going to I'm going to do another circle first. So let's go in here. I want an inward. Let's try 7 millimeters. That looks good. So we'll use that. I also want to have another line that's not as big, and that'll be for our seconds. You'll see how I do this in just a little minute. 2 millimeters, what does 3 look like? I think we'll go with 3 millimeters on that. And then I'm just going to switch layers here, and I'm going to draw a vertical line. Okay, so this isn't what I wanted on the other layer. That's what I wanted on the other layer. And over here, we'll hover over that. This is our offset shape. And what this will do is, when I do both, it does a line to either side. So it makes a rectangle. And I'll make this quite a bit smaller, maybe 0.5 millimeter on each side, so a full millimeter wide. That looks about right. So we'll say OK on that. Now if we go right into the middle, that initial line, let's delete it because we don't need that anymore. Now we can take our new rectangular shape, and then I hold the shift key and select one of the circles, and then I'm going to come down to this, and I'm going to create a circular array. All right, and I want this to rotate, so let me turn that back on. It looks like it's already set to 12, so I get 12 of these, which is exactly what I want. So we'll click OK, and then I'm just going to show this as a fill so we can see this. Turn that on. There we go. All right, so that's starting to look a little bit like a clock. You know, if one of those nice modernistic clocks where it just shows the hours and no numbers, then we'd be done. But we want to do a little bit more with this. So the next step is, again, I'm going to draw a line. Let me turn this off so we don't see that, so it doesn't get in our way. And switch to a new layer. We do a line. This time, I'm just going to go to this intersection. And I click Escape to say I'm done doing lines. Okay, so I'll go back to my pointer. I'll select our line, go back to the rotation tool, open that up, cancel. That's not what I wanted. Let's do this in the right order. Let's do this first. Let's make this not quite as thick as the other one. Make these a little thinner. You can use whatever parameters you want on this. I'm going to make this 0.2 millimeters. So it'll look like that. In comparison, here's our big, fat, juicy one. So I want the seconds to be just a little wispy increment as it goes around. So now I select our hash mark, and holding the shift key, I select one of our circles. And then I'm going to rotate, and that's going to rotate around whatever I chose last because of the way I have this set up. But we don't want 12 of those. How many seconds do we have? 60. So I just type in 60. There we go. Click OK. Turn our other ones back on. Turn these off. Now that's starting to look a lot like a clock. Now I do have these extra can I select one here? There we go. I have these extra hash marks that I really don't need. So by holding the control key, as I go through and select each one of these, it'll let me then delete just those specific ones. Hopefully I don't click the wrong thing. I could do these one at a time. It'd probably be safer than doing them all in one big mass delete. That should be it. I can press the delete key. All right, everything looks good. The next thing we're going to want to do is add some numbers. So again, I'm going to switch to another layer. Hold it. What do you see? I see something. Do you see it? See this red line? We want to get rid of that. And what do you bet that there's a red line hiding underneath each of these guys? Maybe not. We'll find that out later, whether that's happened or not. So let's zoom back out. All right, numbers. That's what we need. So I'm just going to come here randomly somewhere. That's going to be way too big. So we'll just shrink that up. 15. Let's try it. Oops. Type the number 12. That might be a little big. I'm going to go with this. And then we'll take our number 12. And then I'm going to grab one of our circles again. I'm going to hit shift, grab a circle, and then I'm going to line that up so that I'm left and right lined up exactly where I want that to be. And then using the up arrow, I can move that up. That might be a little too high. So using the control key, I'll hold that down, and then my down arrow, that'll move a smaller amount. How does that look? That looks pretty good. So I could do that for each of the times around here, or I could be tricky and do the right thing here. There we go. I want to be, stop. There we go. Select our 12, and let's use our rotate option again. So we'll click, shift click, I should say, one of our circles. Get our rotate. We don't need 60 numbers. How many numbers do we need? 12. Okay. Now, if this is the look you were going for, where you want the letters to turn with the clock, then you could leave it this way. I want all my numbers to be vertical so I can read them when I look at the clock, which is the way most clock faces are set. So I'm going to turn rotate objects off, and then I have a nice number here at each position. Oops. Apparently, I clicked the wrong button. Let's just redo that. 12. Don't rotate. And if you hit OK instead of cancel, apparently that's what you're supposed to do. So I'm going to double-click this, which sends me back into text mode. I'll delete the 2. Come in here. I'll delete the 1. Come in here. I'll delete both and add a 3, come in here, add a 4, and so forth. So this is really easy. It's relatively quick to get through. Oops, I didn't need to get rid of that. Okay. So, here's our clock face. That's literally all that it takes to do a clock face. We can change the font of our numbers. We can make this whole thing bigger or smaller now, which is really nice about using vectors. If we select this whole thing, I can come in here and I can say I want this to be 300. And because it's all vectors, when I zoom in, everything's nice and clean. Looks good. To enhance our clock, one thing that you could do is you could put an image in there. I'm just going to grab this little musical thing that I've got. And I'm going to turn that into vectors as well. So I'm going to do a trace on it. I get a little bit more of this. I'm just going to change my threshold so that it comes out here like that. Kind of looking in this area, trying to grab some of that gray. I'm not quite so much because I'm... Okay, that looks good there. So I'm going to click OK. And then we can get rid of our image. And get that centered up. Oops, I guess I didn't make my circles bigger. Anyway, we should be able to grab this and get it down here. It's a little big, so we'll just shrink it up a little bit. Now you notice that I selected this center dot, and then as I resize this, it will resize based on the center of our object. I'm going to turn these circles back on because I want to use those references again. And I want them to grow from that corner. So I just picked the lower left-hand corner. Now when I click 300, they'll grow up and to the right. That's what I meant to do. Okay, now we can select this, shift, select one of the circles, then I can align and align. There we go. Now if I want to make this bigger or smaller, I'm going to select the center this time so that it grows from the center out. And I'll put this on another layer too, just so we have a little more control over that when it comes time to settings. Okay, just turn that off. Oh. Right, let's do a quick preview. This is what our clock would look like. Of course, there'd be hands, so in the middle there'd be a hole and we'd have the hands and whatnot, but that looks pretty good. And of course, we can go through and we can set our burn parameters to optimize this to something that'll work a little better than that, but that's basically how you make a clock. This picture in the middle could be whatever you want. I just happened to grab this particular one. I could grab other images and place them around here depending on what I was burning. If I was burning something that was a square, I'd have some room up here in the corners. Another option would be to use something instead of numbers. You could use different instruments for each one of the positions. People know what clocks are supposed to be, so you could have a trumpet at number 1 and a tuba at number 2 and a saxophone at number 3, and then just go all the way around having different instruments for each cardinal. Now, of course, 12 is kind of the prestigious spot, so personally that's where I would put the saxophone, although I might put a drum up there too. That's a tricky one. So Maybe maybe a snare drum up at 12 and a saxophone down at number 6. I'll work on that. Anyway, this is the basics of how to create a basic clock face using LightBurn. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you do, please subscribe. If you haven't already, like the video. All of that helps the channel so we can do more educational videos. Anyway, do something in LightBurn. Have fun. It's a great program. And we'll see you in the next video.